Hello everyone and welcome back to Arctic Retro, and in today's video I'm gonna take a look at my Commodore 128D. So I actually got this machine earlier this year and I was really lucky to find one in very good condition. I have always wanted a 128D, and for me it's almost the dream machine. So now I got one, but I didn't have time to take a look at it yet. But today I'm gonna check it out, open it and see the status inside and see if there's anything that needs to be done with it. As you can see, the machine is in a very nice condition, and yeah, the obvious differences between the 128D and the regular 128 is obviously the size, and it has a built-in power supply, built-in 1571 floppy drive and an external keyboard. The machine is of course quite large and yeah, takes up most of the space on my desk, and I have to have my TV on top. I do have a 1084 monitor that I could use with this, but I prefer to use a modern TV. So the picture quality isn't very great. Yeah, as you can see, it has the regular artifacts and jail bars. And the machine has GiffyDOS installed in both the machine and the floppy drive. And the seller even provided me with the original ROMs for the machine, so nice to have those. I did briefly test the machine when I got it, and I had an unboxing video about it. However, before I open the machine, I'm gonna check if it can read a floppy disk. I have booted into C64 mode. Let's see if we can load something. I have a floppy here which should contain some games. Yeah, that loaded nicely. So here we have a leaderboard. Let's try that. And with GiffyDOS, it loads very fast compared to the original machine. Run. All right, so that worked. That's a golf game. I have probably never played it. Okay, I misspelled my name. I'm a novice. All right, so let's give it a try. I'm not really sure how to play. Maybe it is the arrow keys. Anyway, this video is not about playing games, so I'm gonna turn it off. And yeah, let's take a closer look at the machine from all sides and inside. On the right side we have the keyboard connector, and this is a special type of connector. It's like this. It's a 25-pin DB25, is it, or 23? I can't count that fast. And there's the tape port for cassette player and joystick ports, and there's a reset switch. On the back side we have expansion ports. This is for cartridges, the user port, and we have a CGA or RGB out, which actually has this dongle for that makes it possible to use the CGA output on a TV via SCART. And also we have the serial port and the video port and the RF out. And it actually had a switch installed which came out of the machine. I think I have ripped it out now, and this is for switching the ROMs if you don't want to have GiffyDOS, I think. And here we have the label. It says Commodore Model C128D, and this is in fact the metal cabinet. They did produce other variants which had a plastic cabinet, and the serial number 218063. On the other side there's nothing to see except that it looks good. It has a scratch, but that's no problem. Okay, let's open up the machine. It might be in need of some cleaning, I'm not sure. I don't know if the previous owner has done anything. So there's some screws under the machine, and it has some leftovers from the packaging material. So it's a really heavy machine, so I'm actually afraid it will fall over and damage itself or me. It is missing its rubber feet. I'm sure there were some because of the black mark, and those are indented in the case, so I'll need to find some rubber feet on this. So let's see now if we can pull back the case. Yeah. So that's the inside of the 128D, and oh boy, there's a lot of dust. So this actually needs a good cleaning after all. Alright, so what we got here is the power supply, big transformer. It's marked the 10th April 1990. And here's the ROM, Jiffy DOS, and of course this is the floppy drive, the 1571. Actually, I had a plan about building a 128D myself by getting parts, and I actually have one case, and I have a floppy drive, and I have a motherboard. So I was almost there, but it's better to have a completed one. The floppy drive does look a lot cleaner than the rest of the machine, so yeah, that's a bit strange. Maybe it has been replaced at some point. As you can see, the motherboard is very large compared to a regular 128. Here's a 128 board, and as you can see, it's yeah, maybe it's like 50% larger, this one. So this big power supply, there's probably a way to replace that with something more modern. If you have a suggestion of a modern power supply that I can use to replace this old with, then send me a message or a comment in the video. It's a massive one. Okay, so I'm a bit anxious to start tearing this apart now. You know, it is working and everything, but I can't really stand and see all this dust, so at least I need to clean it up, I think. So yeah, there's no way around that but to take it apart. And it shouldn't be too difficult either. I have seen much worse than this. For example, the SX64, that was a nightmare to take apart compared to this. So let me just remove the power supply first. So there's one screw on the side here. I guess that is to the power supply bracket. And there's two screws here on the front. And of course there are one more screw down here on the side. I didn't see that. Now I think the power supply is loose. Yeah, just pull it straight out. Then we have the floppy drive, and I think it's just the four screws. It sits in this bracket here, so I guess it's just these screws. And there's just one screw on this side. A little bit smaller than the others, and it was all loose. And then we need to take off this lever here. And of course the wires, the connectors for the drive. These just pull straight up. So now I think this is loose. Gently pull it straight out. Oh, of course there's that connector there too. Now the motherboard is free to be removed, and there's a lot of screws around the whole board. And oh boy, look at this. That's a lot of dust. Any more screws? I can't see any more screws on the board itself, but I guess these connector screws also need to come up. I have seen that before. So that's another screw on the case. Finally, we have the drive light that also needs to come out, and of course that screw is just in a position that it's hard to reach. I found a thin screwdriver here, just using that, and that works okay. I have unscrewed the front part, so it will be easier to get to that one. Now perhaps we can take the motherboard out. Oh, of course it's this one. Big chunk of metal. Alright, we are in, or we are out. So now I'm gonna take this motherboard down to my garage and blow away all the dust. I can't do that inside here. The case looks very nice. There's no rust or anything, only dust. Just gonna clean off. Well, look at that. The dust is gone, but there is still some dirt on the board, as you can see. So I'm gonna wipe that off with some alcohol. All right, I think that looks a lot better. The underside is completely clean, so no need to do anything there. Now I'm gonna clean up the contacts with some contact cleaner. I'm using a fiberglass pen to brush off the contacts, the edge connectors. All right, I think that's enough with the cleaning. It's a lot better than it was, but there's still more to be cleaned. Actually, I have seen other YouTubers clean their boards in the dishwasher machine, but yeah, I'm a little bit skeptical to that. I don't dare to put a board like this in the dishwasher, because I'm afraid of water coming in through small gaps here and there and starting corrosion. The disk drive just looks remarkably clean. I'm not gonna do anything with it, except I'm gonna clean the drive head a little bit with some alcohol and maybe lubricate the drive rails down here a little bit. Otherwise it looks quite all right. And here we see it's a Mitsumi drive. So the head is a little bit hard to reach, but I have a cotton swab with some alcohol. I'm just gonna wipe gently over it. Then just a little bit of silicone grease on the drive rail, these metal rods that run through the drive mechanism. Alright, so that was the maintenance. Now I'm gonna assemble the machine again and we can take it for a little test. I have attached the switch for the GPDOS ROM switcher, and it was ripped loose from here, so now it just goes out here. And yeah, of course the switch should be permanently installed in the cabinet, but then I need to drill a hole. I'm not gonna do that, I think. one more screw, and that means I did not forget to put back any screws, so the keyboard looks very clean and free of dust, so I'm not gonna open it and clean it, at least not this time. Okay, turning on, let's see if I did anything wrong. No, seems to be working. Excellent. So now I'm gonna actually test that ROM switcher. I'm gonna turn off the machine, then switch and turn back on. Yeah, now it comes with a regular Commodore Basic V7 and the regular Commodore kernel ROM. Alright, let's try a game, and I'm loading Turbo Outrun. And now it is in the regular ROM, so it's not loading very fast. It's so slow. Alright, we're in. Oops. Maybe I should learn to use the brakes and have this turbo button. All right. Oops, police car. Alright, that was fun. The machine works just fine. A great machine. I'm so happy to have one in my collection. Anyway, that was it for this video. I am planning to make a few other videos with this 128D. So you just have to follow my channel if you want to see more. So thanks for watching, and a special thanks to my Patreons. See you. Bye bye.